It's been wonderful to see the story of families who are immigrants to our community in the last 10 years, and now they're having children. So that same story I shared about my family coming here 4 or 5 generations ago, depending on the branch, I'm seeing that now.
Thought Leaders is sponsored by Eastern Gateway Community College. With more than 35 programs, Eastern Gateway can help you with your career preparation and transfer plans.
One of the first times I met you actually was at Revere when you were working there. And I thought that that was such a unique atmosphere and concept, and that a lot of people didn't realize what was happening there was happening in Youngstown. And what I mean by that is not only what was being done there in terms of the work, but just that there were so many bright young people who were coming in from different countries, who perhaps had gone to college in the region and were living in Youngstown and working at Revere. Can you just give us a little sort of snapshot of what Revere was doing in Youngstown at that time and how it was unique for this area?
Revere was started to help to be in the economic classification business and researching supply chains. And that's what we were doing initially. And so a large part of it was trying to understand how the world works. What are emerging technologies in different countries? There's now companies that have an IPO that are making alternative meat. Or they're making exoskeletons to help people walk. And so we're in the economic classification business, helping people make decisions about buying and selling stocks. And to do that, we were recruiting a lot of people who just have a wide, varied background. And so we have people from all over the world that work together and have wonderful potlucks. And the bottom line thing is having a culture and environment that really embodies and embraces diversity. Diversity of background, diversity of thought, diversity of person. And so have been really, really fortunate to have just a wonderful team that we've been able to grow over the years and also just become involved in the community. It's been wonderful to see the story of families who are immigrants to our community in the last 10 years, and now they're having children. So that same story I shared about my family coming here 4 or 5 generations ago, depending on the branch, I'm seeing that now.
You've had young people come from what countries?
From Nepal, from Yemen, from Palestine, from Rwanda, from Europe, from Bosnia Herzegovina. So a very diverse group, and just seeing them also make an impact in the community. Now being on boards here locally, helping other people move forward in their dreams, and just being good people. I'm so lucky to be surrounded by good people at my work.
How important is that to be attracting the best and brightest back to Youngstown?
I think it's very important because we want often to meet people who will recognize not only our talents but our ideas. So I think it can be very deflating if you decide to move back to a place or come to anywhere, and as you share your ideas, what you aspire to be, people don't listen to you. And so how powerful can we be as a community if someone, not even from Youngstown, anyone, my metaphor for Youngstown is a cookie table. Our diversity is our strength. What makes the most beautiful cookie tables is that they're long and filled with baklava and wedding cookies and kolache, and I'll think of all the countries that those cookies represent. And yet there's space for so much more at this cookie table that is our community. And so how do we create a set of table that other people say, I am welcome here, I see myself having a future here, I don't have to be from here to succeed, I have to just be here because I have good ideas. I'm attracted to people that have good ideas and care, and anything that I can do to support those folks who just want to make the community a better place, I'd be honored to do so.
I've met people, like you said, who are not from here, myself included, not far from here, but not from here, and have really become advocates for this area. And then there are the boomerangs. I don't know if you like that term, but yeah. Such as yourself, who have gone away, and you kind of have a pretty tight tribe of them, I think, good friends who have moved back to the area. How do you explain what's happening? Because it's becoming more common, I think.
Yeah, on a personal note, I've just always loved this place. I love the history, I love the people. I'm curious about this place. I love reading old books and history, but I like writing the new history. Mm-hmm. I'm endlessly curious about this as a place because I think it matters in our world. Mm-hmm. I don't think your past really has to dictate your future. But I think that concept of being from a place like this and seeing how the world works and bringing that back is so important. Mm-hmm. Because when I was in school, one of my background degrees is in economic development, science-based economic development. And I'd always beg my professors to try to use Youngstown as a case study. Mm-hmm. And you know, I'd have the one say, okay, yes, you can use Youngstown. But then it would help me to then analyze Youngstown from various economic development strategies and things of that nature. And it was just a very interesting path to be able to get that knowledge of how else the world is working and wanting to apply it to here. And we may have our own Youngstown way, but we're not in a bubble. The world is influencing us in so many ways that we have to be knowledgeable of the outside, but then we have to know what's going on the outside to make this the best mid-sized community that we can make it.
With your background in economics and economic development, we have America Makes here, 3D printing. We may become the hub of electric vehicles. There's talk of that. We have the new track that's going to be going around from Youngstown to downtown. How does this all work together, and how do we keep moving forward in growing this and revitalizing our city?
Well, I think there are two things for sure. You can't put all your eggs in one basket, but then you have to create an ecosystem around each one of those subjects. So it's not just enough to have a business who could be making electric vehicles. You have to invest in the research in your research system at your universities. Who is doing the logic, the algorithms, the sensor design behind creating autonomous vehicles, behind sensor design? You are working in Warren with Bright to make a business incubator there, who is also helping to create that ecosystem. The 3D printing is a really great example. While I am not intensively involved in that from day to day, you see the educational systems here reflecting that in their teaching in the master's and PhD programs. You see it being taught in the community schools or even at the elementary schools and high schools as well. But then you're developing into workforce development, incubating small companies, attracting the branches of established companies that are here. And the hard thing is that takes time. When a place like the Lordstown plant closes, that's such a punch to the gut because that are tens of thousands or thousands of jobs at once. Mm-hmm. And that's a really hard thing to overcome. There's trauma in a community, and we've been through a lot of trauma as a community with that type of thing. And it's slow sometimes to do 3D printing because some people say, well, where are the tens of thousands of jobs? You know, Silicon Valley didn't turn into that overnight. In Portland, they didn't develop a microelectronics industry around there, just because someone wished it to be so. You have to look at it in the long run, and you have to develop things up and down that both physical and intellectual supply chain. We need to do it for 3D printing, for autonomous vehicles, if that's a direction that we feel like we have the capacity to. You also have to have the capacity to do it. You can wish things to be true, but unless you're willing to put in the millions of dollars of infrastructure that takes to do that, to build your commercialization centers, to make your incubators, we need so much more of that.
Thought Leaders is sponsored by Eastern Gateway Community College. With more than 35 programs, Eastern Gateway can help you with your career preparation and transfer plans.